我们一起的来读一处的经文。
Let's read from one Bible passage.
在第三课我们起的目的第生命记第八章。
From Deuteronomy chapter 8.
我们一起的来读十八节到二十节。
From verses 18 to 20.
我们照样的也来先把中文读完，然后再读英文。
Similarly, we'll start reading the Chinese version, then comes the NIV English version.
生命记第八章十八节到第
二十节。Deuteronomy chapter 8, verse 18 to 20.
还是你们课本能够找到第几面，跟大家讲一下。
六十九页。
好，三二一，起。现在we start with English, okay? Deuteronomy chapter 8, verse 18 to 20. Okay, 3, 2, 1, start.
But remember the Lord your God, for it is He who gives you the ability to produce wealth, and so confirms His covenant which He swore to your ancestors as it is today. If you ever forget the Lord your God and follow other gods and worship and bow down to them, I testify against you today that you will surely be destroyed. Like the nations the Lord destroyed before you, so you will be destroyed for not obeying the Lord your God. Let's pray.
天父，我们求你赐给我们足够的心力、灵力和体力。
Lord, we ask that you will strengthen our spirit, soul, and body.
特别的是在一个很疲倦的下午的时候。
Especially in a tiring afternoon.
我们求主，你让我们除去我们身体上一切的疲惫。
Take away all weariness of the body.
我们求按着真理的圣灵。
We pray that the spirit of truth.
按着神丰盛的荣耀
，according to the truth and glorious abundance，
叫我们的心里的力量刚强起来。
That our inner strength is strengthened。
主啊，求你恩待我们。
Lord, have favor upon us。
当我们一起的来思考企业的目的的时候
，as we contemplate on the purpose of entrepreneurship，
让我们从一个高度看见我们做企业的目的。
That we will be able to see our purpose from the height。
求你借助你的话语教导我们。
May you teach us with your word.
奉耶稣宝贵名祈求。
In the precious name of our Lord Jesus Christ, we pray.
Amen.
Amen.
好，我请你大家鼓励隔壁的弟兄姐妹，因为在下午有人看，我讲道是看你们的眼睛啊。
So encourage the person next to you because when I preach, I look at your eyes.
所以你。讲阿妹在那边打瞌睡，我不知道。
So you say amen or by nodding your head, I know whether it's amen or not, or doze off to sleep.
我知道肉体软弱，心灵愿意，可是肉体软弱。
I know that the spirit is willing, but the body is weak.
可是我们真的要靠主而来警醒。
So we need to stay alert, by God.
所以我告诉我们的会长说，我们下午真的要有够的灵力啊。
Yeah, our chairman says that we need to have this strength in spirit.
好，我们一起的来看今天我们要做读的经文。
So we look into the passage for this afternoon.
首先，我们要纪念耶和华。
Firstly, we need to remember the Lord God.
我们知道，在旧约里面最高的启示就是神启示他的名字。
So the highest revelation in the Old Testament is revealing His name.
就是耶和华。
That is Jehovah.
中国大陆的弟兄姐妹说，哇，真的很好，这个名字。
Chinese delegates, China Christian in China, they love this word, Jehovah.
哇，上帝的名字太美了。
So it's a, such a beautiful name of the Lord.
耶稣加上华人就叫耶和华。
It's because it's Jehovah is the Yeh, it refers to Jesus, and Hua is the Chinese. So Jesus plus Chinese is Jehovah.
当然，耶和华不是这个意思。
Of course, that's not the meaning of Jehovah.
其实我们知道，在最新的翻译版，把它称为亚伟。
In the newest translation, address God's name as Yahweh.
在犹太人来说，这个名字是不能叫的。
For the Jews, they can't address the name of God.
因为犹太人跟我们中国人一样的有一种。对一个尊敬的人或是一个尊敬的创造主他们有那种避讳
So we have this the Jews and the Chinese has this culture called filial piety they try to exempt from addressing the person's name
换句话说你不会叫你的老豆或是你的爸爸他的名字
So for example you will not address your father by name
可是呢不像我们西方的人就我们叫他没大没小。
So in Western worlds, we address the persons by name. We do not actually put the filial piety into practice.
所以我们不管他的身份多高，我们都是叫他的名字。
So yeah, regardless how the position that the person has, we just address that person by name.
可是我们在希伯来人的民族跟中华民族呢，我们对一个尊敬的名字呢是一种庇护。
So in the Chinese culture or Jews, we have this reverence towards a person.
所以呢，在希伯来文化里面，神的名字是不可以叫的。
So in Hebrew's culture, they could not call the name of God.
换句话说，它是没有 vowels， 是不能拼的。
So in other words, there's no vowel in the name of God, therefore it can't be pronounced.
所以在我们的英文的圣经里面，通常呢，比如说和合本，我们都是把它翻成 Lord, Lord， 可是都是大写的。
So you can see that basically in the translation, we'll use the word Lord in capital letter.
然后如果你看到英文里面有 Lord， 后面 Ord 小写呢？这个主呢跟这个是不一样的，这个就是耶和华，这个呢其实叫 Adonai。
So you can see that the capital letter or the small letters refers to the Adonai and Lord refers to Yahweh。
所以呢，在神的名字里面
，So in the name of God，
你发现有三个很重要，一个叫做 Yahweh。
Oh, there are three concepts. The first is Yahweh。
这是可以经历的上帝
，a God that you can experience。
我们可以说是他，我们是我们的中保 mediator。
So he is our mediator。
可是他也是 Adonai。
He is also the Adonai。
他也是我们的主 master。
He is also our master。
然后呢，还有一个名字，我们通常把它称为 Elohim。
So another name is Elohim。
这个 Elohim 我们翻译也是神，我们翻译出，可是也是 Maker。
So he is the Maker。
这个是大卫在诗篇十六篇的时候，他同时把神这个三个名字都叫出来。
So in Psalm 16, these three names are being mentioned。
换句话，他不只是创造主。
In other words, he's not just our Maker。
他也是我们生命的主。
He's our life's master。
他也是。我们可以经历的这位上帝
，and he is the mediator where we can experience him。
所以，当我们提到耶和华的时候
，so when we make mention Jehovah，
耶和华这个名字是让我们可以经历的
，and Jehovah is a name that we can experience。
摩西问上帝说：“你要我去把这些百姓从埃及里面救出来，你要告诉我你叫什么名字，好叫我去带他们出来的时候可以告诉他们。
So when God called Moses to lead the people out of Egypt, and he says, "God, please let me know your name so that I can let the people know who's the God that called me."
所以呢，在出埃及第三章的时候，上帝就启示了他的名字。所以我们可以说最。旧约里面最高的启示就是上帝告诉我们他的名字。
So in the book of Exodus chapter 3, that's the highest revelation of himself by letting Moses know his name.
我们英文的翻译版叫做 I am who I am.
So that's the English translation for Yahweh is I am who I am.
中文叫我是。
But in Chinese, it's only I am.
可是我们中文的翻译是不是是自由拥有的上帝？
So he's an everlasting God.
其实
ever living God.
我是。
I am.
是礼拜天当主耶稣他在旧约呢是以耶和华的身份出现的。
So Jesus in the Old Testament present himself as Jehovah.
所以当他在旧约里面在新约的时候，他说我是的时候。犹太人就要用石头打他。
When Jesus in the New Testament make mention his name is I am, and the Jews wants to stone him to death.
因为他们认为他是在亵渎上帝。
Because to them, the Jews, that Jesus is blaspheming God's name.
你发现这个名字。
You can see that this name
叫做我是。
I am.
我是可以让你去填充的。
I am, you can actually fill in the blanks.
我是可以完整的句子。
But it can be also a statement by itself.
可是我是在这里是让每一个信靠上帝的人可以在你后面让你填充。
So I am, you can allow those who believe in God to fill up the experience at the back.
所以耶和华
in Jehovah, therefore,
在旧约里面出现很多次。
So in the Old Testament appeared quite frequent.
这位上帝是可以让我们去经历的。
Because this God is God that, that will help us to experience Him.
我比一个例子。
For example,
从诗篇二十三篇。
From Psalm chapter 23.
耶和华罗伊。
Jehovah Rohi.
我是你的牧者。
I am your shepherd.
是第一个名字耶和华罗伊。
That's Jehovah Rohi.
I am Rohi.耶和华罗伊，我是你的牧者。
I am Rohi, your shepherd.
我并不紧缺乏。
And I lack nothing.
我是耶和华以勒的上帝。
Because I am Jehovah Jireh.
现在你明白怎么叫以勒了吗？
Now you understand why it's called Jireh?
以勒就是上帝是我们的供应。
Because Jireh is God, our provider.
他是我们的预备。
He prepared for us.
即使在创世纪第二十二章说当上帝预备这个羔羊来代替以撒的时候，他说，在耶和华的山上，神必预备。
So in Genesis chapter 22, when the Lord prepared a ram for Abraham to sacrifice instead of Isaiah, he said, in the mountain of the Lord, the Lord will prepare.
所以在新约的时候，保罗回应在腓立比书第四章六十九节说，神必按照他一切的丰盛，在基督里。充充足足的供应你一切所需所求的。
And Paul in Philippians says that God will provide all for us with the abundance that's found in Christ.
然后他使我躺卧在青草地上，领我可到安歇的水边。
So he makes me lie in green pasture and beside still waters.
他是耶和华沙龙。
He is Jehovah Shalom.
他是赐人意外平安的上帝。
So he is the God that gave us peace that surpasses all understanding.
神给的平安不是从这个世界来。
So the peace from God is not of this world.
耶和华沙龙。
He is Jehovah Shalom.
他使我的灵魂苏醒。
So he refreshes our soul.
他是耶和华拉法。
He is Jehovah Rapha.
他是医治我们的上帝。
God that healeth us.
所以呢
？Therefore.
你发现今天躺在病院里面的人
，So those who are lying in the sick bed in the hospital，
其实医学上我们把它称为有百分之三分之二的人就是 due to EII emotional induced illness。
2/3 of them are being called emotional induced illnesses， 就是呢
，psychosomatic disease， 身体心理造成的身体的病。
Yeah， it actually comes from the emotional that cause。Illnesses to the body.
其实耶和华是拉法是我的医治者。
Jehovah Rapha is my healer.
我可以见证这位神是又真又活的。
I can testify that he is a true and living God.
神呼召我出来列国的时候
，When God called me into the nations,
魔鬼也攻击我很厉害。
And I received this the attack from the devil.
突然身体好好的，突然间好像癌症也有了，什么都有了。
All of a sudden, my whole body turned bad.
是神很奇妙的医治。
But God healed me marvelously.
有，当我在前几年，我一
So in my initial years, I need to preach many sessions in the day. Thank God for one of more co-workers nowadays. Back then, I'm a lone ranger. Traveling the world by alone. So whenever I'm being invited, they will squeeze everything out of me. Now from day to night, I'll be preaching. But I don't know how to say no. There's 1 year I preached 800 sessions. So I've lost my voice as a result of that. And when I go for a consultation and the doctor was surprised. So there's this ulcer in my vocal cord. So this lump is so big that I need to go for an operation. So I said, if I were to go for an operation, how long I need to rest before I can preach again? That's a Christian doctor and says, I will find the best specialist for you. He is a specialist by profession. But I said, I dare not perform this operation on you. So if you can't preach as a result of the operation, then I will be guilty the rest of my life. So I said, I will find the best specialist to perform the operation for you. But at least you need half a year to rest before you can speak again. Marvelously. So he said, by hearing this 6 months break, and I look at the calendar and say, oh, I need to apologize to many. So I sent, in the shortest time, I sent this prayer request to the prayer network, my prayer network. So many prayed for me. So I hold on to the very promises of the Bible. In Proverbs chapter 4, verses 20-22. So this is the first aid box of God.
Medicine box of God.
Yeah, the medicine box.
他说你若你留心听我的言辞，侧耳听我的话语，这一切不离开我的眼目，你得着就得着生命，并得着一全体的良药。
He says, "My son, pay attention to what I say. Turn your ears to my word. Do not let them out of sight. Keep them within your heart, for they are life to those who find them, and health to one's whole body."
我发现这些经文给我们应许说神话。
So this is a promise that says that the word of God has healing element in it. That so marvelously. When my next visit to the doctor, she said, once after the check, said the lump has actually decreased, so do not need an operation. So I have actually not done any operation for these past years. But back then, I could not really speak. But God, for the past years, He has been healing me. My voice sounds like Rod Stewart. It's very, very interesting. Because I believe in God Rapha, my healer. I just touched the surface. But every word of God is with power. He refreshes my soul. For His name's sake, that He leads me in the path of righteousness. He is Jehovah Shikanu. That I could clothe the righteousness of Christ.
主啊，他若称我为义，还有谁能定我的罪呢？
If he declares me as righteous, who can condemn me?
有谁能够控告神所拣选的人？
Who can accuse the chosen of God?
虽然我行过死荫的幽谷，
Even though I walk through the darkest valley,
我必不怕遭害。
I fear no evil,
因为你的杖、你的竿都安慰我。
For your rod and the staff, they comfort me.
那是耶和华撒玛。
That's Jehovah Shammah.
神就在那里。
God is there.
你发觉要经过低谷，第五节才得胜。
So you have to go through the darkest valley, and you will see victorious in verse 5.
今天很多人想要得胜，可是却没有征战。
So many wants victory, but without battle.
这不是不合逻辑的。
So this is illogical.
没有征战，怎么有胜利呢？
Without battle, how can you experience victory?
没有仇敌挡门，怎么有开门呢？
No, without this opposition from the enemy, where's the way out?
所以第五节说，在我的敌人面前为我摆设宴席。
So in verse 5 says that before my presence of my enemy, the Lord prepared the table.
他用油膏了我的头。
He anoints my head with oil.
使我福杯满溢。
That my cup overflows.
膏就是 triple anointing， 就是这个三重的恩膏。
So the anointing is a threefold anointing.
耶和华尼西。
Jehovah Nissi.
他是为我征战的上帝。
He is the God that battled for me.
他为我征战，我一个人可以追赶一千人。
If he battled for me, one can chase after 1,000.
两个人可以使一万个人逃跑。
Two will put 10,000 to flight.
所以你发觉，
耶
和华。
Jehovah
是让你可以经历的这位。
It's the God that you can experience.
可是让那些每个信靠的人，让你填充。
And for those who believe in God, can fill in the blanks.
你要记得纪念耶和华。
You have to remember the Lord.
你的上帝。
Your God.
你要纪念，因为是他让你突破的。
You have to remember Him because it's He who let you experience the breakthrough.
所以。你要纪念，换句话，你要休息，知道他是上帝。
You have to remember. In other words, you need to rest in order to know that he is God.
四十六篇十节。
In Psalm chapter 46 verse 10.
很多人不知道什么叫做安息的一个安息日的真意。
Many do not know what it means to have a Sabbath.
所以变成很多的律法。
So therefore, a lot of legal.Attachment to it.
安息是让我们休息，知道他是上帝。
So rest is for us to know to know God.
要知道的获财的能力是他给的。
To know that the ability to gain wealth is from Him.
你的时间谁给的？
Who gave you the time?
上帝就不给你多一秒，你都不能活多一秒。
If God do not allow you to stay a second, you could not live a second more.
上谁给你才干？
Who gave you the talent?
上帝给的。
God is the one.
谁给你这些精力去赚取这些钱财？
Who gave you the experience to gain wealth?
可是很常我们企业家常常落在一个关景里面，我们成功了就忘记了上帝。
So we often entrepreneurs will fall into this pitfall. That is when we succeed, we forget the Lord.
我们慢慢以为这些是我们努力赚来的。
So we keep telling ourselves this is all because of our hard work that we come to this stage.
上帝，你看我长得英俊一点，所以你对我好一点。
Lord, because I'm so handsome looking, therefore you treat me well.
上帝啊，你看我多么聪明，我赚了这么多钱。
So I'm so brilliant, therefore I'm able to earn that much.
无知的人忘记了这一切都是上帝的。
So the fool forgets that all this comes from the Lord.
所以呢，我们做企业的目的。
Therefore, the purpose of entrepreneurship.
我们千万不要忘记，我们一切所有都是上帝来的。
So do not forget that all that we have comes from the Lord.
我们要纪念耶和华你的上帝。
We have to remember the Lord our God.
我们要得获财的力量是他给的。
So the ability to produce wealth comes from Him.
因为为什么呢？为要上帝要我们纪念他，是因为神要为我们坚定他向我们所立的约。
Because God wants us to remember Him so that He confirms the covenant that He made with us.
圣经里面特别讲到神跟人立约。
In the Bible, God talks about the covenant between man and God.
很多时候很多人不明白，这个业是有条件的还是没有条件的。
So at times we are confused whether it's conditional or unconditional.
神为什么要坚定这个业呢？
Why does God want to confirm this covenant?
你发觉圣经里面从头到尾，上帝是要跟人立业的，要做他的上帝，他们要做他的子民。
So you can see that God wants to confirm this covenant. He wants to be their God and the people, they are His people.
我们要知道。在旧约里面的业呢，是啊、在这个业里面，在原文里面，他用了当时中东的一个业的条件，叫做 Suzerain vessel。
So this covenant is based on this concept in the Middle East. It's called Suzerain vessel.
这是宗主附庸的意思。
So it's the Suzerain means the Lord, and vessel is the subject.
主跟我们这些附庸。
And the Lord and subject,
我们这个附庸呢，就好像大臣一样，我们是他的臣民。
So the subject is to serve.
他跟我们的关系。
So like the official, there's a relationship between the Lord and
officials. 若我们顺服他的诫命。
So if we were to obey his command,
就带来祝福。
And we receive blessing in return.
我们若背逆他的诫命。
If we disobey,
就带来咒诅。
So we receive curse.
所以这个业是有。条件的。
So this covenant is conditional covenant.
感谢主。
Thank God.
我们的业是凭着亚伯拉罕立的。
Thank God that our covenant is based on Abraham.
因为亚伯拉罕的业是没有条件。
Because Abraham's covenant is unconditional.
亚伯拉罕神跟他立业的时候
，When God made a covenant with Abraham,
上帝使亚伯拉罕沉睡了。
And it caused Abraham to a deep sleep.
睡代表死人。
Now sleep represents death.
所以上帝如大火把，把这个走在这个两个分开的祭圣当中来立这个业。
So as this flame of fire walked through the sacrifice and to establish this covenant.
就像我们今天我们信耶稣的人。
Just as us, the one that believe in Christ.
我们本来是死在罪恶过患当中
的。So we die in our sin and trespasses.
死人，你跟死人立业。
A dead and establish a covenant with them.
亚伯拉罕之业叫做信心之业。
But Abraham's covenant is called faith covenant.
这个信心之业是没有条件的。
This faith covenant is unconditional.
因为你跟这些死人谈什么条件？
Now, if you talk to a dead people, what covenant are you going to?
我们本来死在罪恶过患当中的人，上帝叫我们活过来。
So we die in sins and trespasses, yet God asked to raise us from the dead.
所以呢，这是回应以弗所书第二章八节到九节所讲的。
So this is in response to Ephesians chapter 2, verses 8 and 9.
他说我们得救本乎恩，也因着信，乃是上帝所赐的。
He says, for it's by grace that you have been saved through faith, which is a gift from God.
连这个信心都是上帝给的。
So even the faith comes from God.
连这个信心都不是你的。
This faith doesn't belong to you.
所以上帝给我们这个得救的信心。
God gave us this faith of salvation.
换句话说
In other words,
我们本来死的。
We are dead before.
可是上帝叫我们活过来。
But God raised us from the dead.
他怎样叫我们活过来呢？
How does he do it?
所以他必须召我们。
He has to call us.
他要恩召我们，完全是恩典。
By grace, he called us out.
叫做恩典的呼召。
That's the grace of call.
然后他重生了我们。
And resurrect us.
重生了我们有生命了。
That we have life once again.
然后我们才有得救的信心。
That we have this faith of salvation.
然后我们才能悔改。
And then we'll be able to repent.
所以这个是救恩的次序。
So this is the process, the sequence of
salvation. 所以你发现开始是完全没有条件的。
So in other words, in the beginning, we have no conditional at all.
亚伯拉罕之约是信心之约。
The Abraham's covenant is a covenant of faith.
然后呢？可是你活过来有责任吗
？So we, once we're born again, we, do we have responsibility?
有了。
Yes.
所以你发现以弗所书第二章八节到九节到十节就讲说我们原是他的工作。
So when it comes to verse 10 in Ephesians chapter 2, it says that we are God's handiwork.
换句话是神预备我们去行的。
In other words, it's God that prepared us to put into practice.
我们是他的工作在基督里造成的。
So we are being created in Christ as his handiwork.
所以答案是呢业是有条件的，也没有条件的。
So the answer is, does this conditional or unconditional covenant?
一开始是没有条件的。
In the beginning, it's unconditional.
你必须活过来。
You have to be born again once.
就好像我们被重生在上帝的国度里面。
That means to born again into God's kingdom.
我们不能够说，哎，我选谁来生我，谁能够这么做呢？
So we can't choose who we want to be birthed from. We can't choose, right?
你不能选你的母亲。
So we can't choose who our mother is.
完全是恩典。
It's all by grace.
你被圣灵重生，完全是恩典。So being, 不在乎于你。
Being born of the Holy Spirit is also by grace. You have no choice in it.
那个信心职业一点条件都没有。
So there's no requirement condition in this faith covenant.
可是你从你母亲的腹中生出来的时候，你说我不要生，我要赚回去，可以吗？
So when you are being birthed, can you say that? Oh, I do not want to come out. I need to go back. Can you do that?
你一重生了，你开始长大了，就慢慢有责任。
So when once you are born, as you keep growing, you have responsibility.
所以加拉太书第四章四节说。
So in Galatians chapter 4 verse 4, it says,
第四章一节。
Galatians chapter 4 verse 4.
讲到以色列人。
It talks about Israelites.
他们虽然是前业的主人，
even though they are the owner of the former covenant,
可是呢，他做孩童的时候还是看在律法和先啊师父和律法之下。
So when they are still young, they are under a teacher and guardians.
换句话说，他们在律法跟先知的之下。
So in other words, they are under the law and the prophets.
可是他慢慢长大的，他是越来越有责任的。
So as he grew, he has greater responsibility.
所以你发现，当圣经里面讲到西乃之业的时候，是有条件的。
So when the Bible talks about the covenant of Sinai, that's conditional.
他已经是上帝的儿女。
Because they are the children of God.
他是有责任的。
Therefore, that's responsibility.
所以我们不要混淆这两方面，需要整合。
So we do not confuse of the two, but we need to integrate the both. Integrate both.
开始是没有条件，过后是有条件。
So in the beginning is unconditional, but as we progress, there's condition.
所以他说，为了坚定神向我们所立的约。
In order to confirm the covenant that He made with us.
你要记得，神对我们立约是要赐福给我们。
The covenant that God made with us is to bless us.
所以呢，让我们可以创造财富。
Therefore, we are able to produce wealth.
给我们得到自由。
To give us freedom.
今天没有自由的人能够敬拜上帝吗？
For those who are without freedom, can they worship God?
埃及的人做在埃及，以色列人在埃及的时候，他们为奴的时候，他们侍奉的是法老。
So when the Israelites are in Egypt, they are enslaved, their Lord is Pharaoh.
他不能侍奉上帝。
They can't serve the Lord.
因为圣经讲，一个人不能侍奉两个主。
Because the Bible says that we cannot serve two masters.
你不是侍奉法老，你就侍奉上帝。
If you are not serving the Pharaoh, then you serve the Lord.
法老代表的是魔鬼。
So Pharaoh represents the devil.
他们在埃及里面的时候。
In Egypt.
他是在埃及里面为奴。
So they are enslaved in Egypt.
时间不是他的。
Time is not theirs.
时间是法老的。
It's all the Pharaoh.
法老叫他们做工就做做工。
So when the Pharaoh instruct them to work, they have to work.
他们可以买财产吗？
Can they buy any possessions?
不能，因为他们是属于法老的。
No. Because they belong to Pharaoh.
他们没有金钱。
They do not have wealth.
没有时间。
Without time.
没有自由。
Without freedom.
他们就是有才干，也不能发挥。
So even though they have this talent, they can't express that talent.
所以上帝就叫摩西。
Because therefore God called Moses.
你去跟法老说。
You say go and see the Pharaoh.
所以出埃及记第八章一节跟九章一节就同样重复了同一个话。
So in Exodus chapter 8 verse 1 and chapter 9 verse 1 repeat the same word.
他说用我的百姓去。
So allow my people to go.
换句话说，你们再也不要做奴隶，你们要从埃及出来。
In other words, no longer be enslaved. You need to come out from Egypt. 你
要用我的百姓去。
And allow my people go.
目的是什么？
What's the purpose?
好叫他来侍奉我。
So that they could serve me.
是圣经非常的清楚。
Therefore, the Bible is so clear on this.
我们做企业。
So as entrepreneurs,
我们得财富的自由。
So we are to receive freedom of wealth.
我们得到时间的自由。
We have this freedom of time.
我们有时间来发展我们的才干。
So we have time to explore and develop our talents.
我们能够发掘、发挥、发展、发挥我们的恩赐。
We can discover, develop, and deploy our talents.
使得我们能够来侍奉上帝。
So that we can serve the Lord.
所以企业的目的。
Therefore, the purpose of entrepreneurship.
不是让你肥自己。
It's not to just put ourselves enrich yourself.
企业有很清楚的目的。
So that's a very clear purpose in.
企业的目的是让你财富上得到自由。
That is to allow you to experience freedom in wealth.
感谢主，在我们全球做这些企业家培训的时候
，So as we conduct this entrepreneurship training globally，
我发现很多企业家现在慢慢有自由了。
So I can see that there are many entrepreneurs now they experience freedom。
虽然他跟我讲说，哎呀，公司不在，每天不知道损失了多少钱。
So say I'm not in the office, and I don't know how much do I'm wasting away。
他们现在可以来到，甚至我们一些特会，一个星期都可以在我们当中。
But nowadays, when we have this one-week training, they are able to attend.
就像我们的万里马一样。
Just as our sister Chiron.
我们的千里羊一样。
Sorry,
这个羊跟马，全世界都跑。
So both of them follow me to the world.
我相信他们跑不会因为生意不好，对不对？
I believe that they are away. It's not because their business are not doing well.
他们有时间的自由。
Because they have this freedom of time.
他们可以做出他要的选择。
So they can decide what they want.
他有。财富的自由。
They have the freedom in wealth.
他有可以用时间来发挥他的恩赐。
They can actually use time to express their talents.
所以企业的目的。
So the purpose of entrepreneurship.
我们再也不要侍奉这个埃及的王。
So no longer to serve the king of Egypt.
埃及代表世界。
So Egypt represents the world.
世界的王就是魔鬼。
So the king of the world is the devil.
我们不要侍奉巴比伦系统。
We do not want to serve in this Babylonian system.
有两个城是对立的。
So there are two cities that is in contrast.
一个是巴比伦城，一个是耶路撒冷。
So there's these two cities, the Babylon and also the Babylon and also the Jerusalem.
巴比伦城会一天完全倾倒。
So one day Babylon, the dynasty will collapse.
所以在启示录第十八章四节说。
So therefore in Revelation chapter 18, chapter 8.18 verse 4.
他说：“我的民啊，你们要从这个城，这个城所指的就是巴比伦城，要从这个城出来，免得你与他们一同有罪，与他们受同样的灾殃。”
So my people come up from Babylon, do not be judged together with the people.
我们这个课程是帮助我们从巴比伦系统进入一个国度的系统。
So this course helps us to move out from Babylonian system into the kingdom system.
所以下个课里面我们讲到国度的经济。
So the next session we'll talk about the economics of the kingdom.
你发现神的经济跟国度的跟世界的经济刚好是反过来的。
So you can see that it's a total opposite of the kingdom economics and the worldly economics.
所以下一课也就是我们最疲倦那一课，可是非常重要的一课。
So our next session perhaps will be the most exhausting one, but that's the so important one.
我们要进入国度的经济。
Because we are going to enter into the economic system.
这一课我们要讲我们企业的目的是什么。
So this session we talk about the purpose of our entrepreneurship.
我们这一课的企业的目的是要教我们侍奉他。
So this session is to teach us to serve him.
你要知道耶和华所赐的福并不加上忧虑。
So you know that the blessing of God would not add any worry to it.
Yeah. 其实这是箴言书十章二十二节。
This is from book Proverbs chapter 10 verse 22.
他说耶和华所赐的福使人富足，可是并不加上忧虑。
He says that the blessing of the Lord brings wealth and without painful toil for it.
真正从神来的祝福是让我们各方面身心灵都是蒙福的。
So the true blessing of God causes and enriches us in spirit, soul, and body.
可是你看见今天很多富足的人，财富上自由。祝福人他们有没有福气呢？他们没有。
So you can see that a lot of rich today, but they seems like they receive blessing, but they are not.
他们似乎钱越多越烦恼。
But the greater wealth they are, the worry they will be.
财富越多越头痛。
So the greater the wealth, the greater the headache.
所以呢，我根据一个国际的调查里面，很难找到一个财主他是快乐的。
So through this global research, find that it's difficult to find a happy, wealthy person.
因为他忘记了他是应该金钱的主人，他反而会成为金钱的奴隶。
So they've forgotten that they are the master of wealth, but they are now the slave of wealth.
所以当一个人有钱的人，如果我们不懂得怎么去应用成为好管家的话，我们可能会成为财奴。
So if you do not know how to utilize our wealth to be a good steward, we will be enslaved by wealth.
耶和华所赐的福使人富足，并不加上忧虑。
So the blessing of the Lord brings wealth without painful toil for it.
现在我们要来看这个目的。
So let's look into the purpose.
我们来看这个目的的时候
，When we look into the purpose,
我们要记得，只有在基督里面的侍奉才是侍奉。
So the true service is in Christ.
所以我们要从基督的范本来看这三方面的侍奉。
So we are going to look into these three areas of service in Christ's template.
我顺便这边讲一下。
So I would like to address this as well.
你如果发现中国印的圣经
，So if you notice the Chinese, the Bible printed in China.
他们所用的侍奉的事是这个事，而不是这个事。
So the Chinese word for service, the upper ones refers to the Chinese, the Bible printed in China, and the other is the other printers.
很简单，因为在中国的词海找不到这两个字。
Because in the vocabulary or in China, they could not find this word.
可是我告诉你，这是正确的，这是错的。
So the bottom word is the right words, and that's with error on top.
你知道我们中文和合本圣经是什么时候翻的吗
？Do you know that the Chinese the Union Bible, you know when it's being translated?
在翻的时候是在1919年的时候。
So it's in the year 1919.
也是白话文运动的时候。
Oh, that's where the common Chinese word, Chinese language is populated.
而那个时候呢？在翻译圣经里面没有一个华人，一个都没有。
So the translator, Bible translator back then, there's none Chinese among them.
都是拐佬。
All of them are westerners.
都是那些海外来的博士啊，神学家。
So they are actually PhD holders, professors from overseas.
你发现他们能够把中文和合本翻得这样棒不棒
？So they are able to translate the Chinese Bible.
所以我至今100年了，我还用和合本。
So after 100 years, I'm still using the Chinese Union Bible.
和合本用的就是这个侍奉的事。
So that's the bottom word that is being used for service.
他们来翻到圣经，翻到这个时候，这点的时候。
So when you come to this particular word for service,
他们有一个难题。
So they are faced with this dilemma.
他们在研究原文的时候。
So as they study the original text.
讲到侍奉的时候。
When they talk about this word service.
讲到敬拜的时候。
Worship.
他们很难找一个中文字来代替。
So you can't find a Chinese word or vocabulary to represent.
所以这两个字是他们发明出来的。
So they created this word.
因为所以侍奉。有三方面的。
So there are three aspects to the word service.
我们很长的时候，我们以为侍奉就是坐坐那个搬搬椅子坐，以为坐这是错的。
So oftentimes you thought that service is like doing a task.
我们英文可能就容易明白一点。
For the English perhaps it's easier to understand.
我们知道我们要有 being 才能够 doing.
So we understand we need to be in before we do.
我们的身份界定我们做什么事。
Because our identity determines what we do.
所以我们叫 human being, 我们不是叫 human doing.
Therefore we call ourselves human being and not human doing.
所以呢，神很看重你的存在。
Therefore God treasure value your existence.
所以圣经说没有生命的侍奉就不可能有工作的侍奉。
So without the life service, there will be not any work service.
这个两个字所强调的是一个工作的侍奉。
So the upper service word is actually work, is a work service.
所以他用这个是，是代表是一个工作的观念。
So that's an assignment, a service that the things that you do.
而他们在发明这个字的时候很有意思，是凡事奉主的名做事。
But when we develop the second word, is in all things that you do things in the name of God.
或许我不在基督里面做的都不是。
In other words, that whatever that you do out of Christ is not service at all.
所以在基督里是需要三方面的。
So in order to be in Christ, you need these threefold aspects.
所以呢，我把它翻成这个仁义、真理、君、真理、仁义和圣洁在基督里面的侍奉是什么
？Therefore, I translate that into righteousness, truth, and holiness.
你发现这个侍奉呢，是需要有包括这个听命，然后我们首先要从臣服，然后听命，然后来遵行。
So we have to be firstly to submit and to listen and to obey then.
Yeah. Maybe easier for me to tell a story for the English speaker because I'm doing a lot of Chinese stuff.
那我就觉得是那就让我以中文来英文来去分享有关这个的解释。
There is an old minister who brought a small boy, to Sunday service one day.
那一个长者牧者呢就带了一个小朋友呢一个小男孩的去参加一个崇拜。
You know, in the Western world, Normally, in behind the church, there is always a graveyard.
那你知道，一般上在传统的这个教堂的时刻，在教堂的后方呢，就有那一个的坟墓。
In New Zealand, Australia, we usually have the, you know, a lot of soldiers who die to remember those soldiers who died in the war.
那就好像是在澳洲或者在纽西兰呢，我们就有这个的坟场来去纪念殉命的那个的兵士。
So there's a lot of.Soldier who died in the national service.
就是呢，在国的国防的这个服务中呢，而殉道的，这是死去的。
So this old minister who brought the small boy past the graveyard.
这个年长的牧者呢，就把这个小孩带经过这个的坟墓的时候
，behind the church.
就在那个教堂的后方。
He tell the little boy.
就告诉那个小朋友。
He said, "Yeah, boy."
他说，小朋友。
Do you know this man?Die in the service.
你知道这一群人呢，就是在服侍的时候而死。
The boy answered, "Did they die in the morning service or afternoon service?"
他说这个的服侍是指呢，这个的崇拜是在早上的崇拜或者是晚上的崇拜。
So you understand the word service and worship, there's a connection.
那其实这一个字呢，这个服侍呢和敬拜其实是有关联的。
Normally we say we go to morning service or afternoon service.
在英文
worship we call worship.
那在英文呢，我们说是就是早堂的敬拜或者是晚堂的敬拜，是用这个字 service。
其实，我们要知道，当中我们圣经所用的这个侍奉，
是的
是包括敬拜跟赞美。
那 and the service that we mentioned in the Bible includes praise and worship。
你发现敬拜跟赞美
，you can see that the two words。Worship and praise.
We should say worship and praise rather than praise and worship.
那我们应该是说呢，敬拜赞美，而不是赞美敬拜。
Because without worship, there is no praise.
因为呢，没有敬拜就没有赞美。
Because worship,
因为敬拜
is the inner life.That God to declare God is God.
那是呢，你们内在的生命宣告着呢，神就是神。
敬拜呢是，换句话说，就像耶伯一样，当什么都不好的时候，上帝把一切都取走的时候，他说赏赐的是耶和华，收起的也是耶和华。耶和华的名是应当称颂的。
Just as Job, when all things are turned bad and everything are lost, he says that it's God who give and God who take it back. All glory be unto God. That's worship.
无花果树不发旺。
So even though the fig tree does not bear fruit,
葡萄树不结果。
And the vine yard does not bear fruit as well.
橄榄树不效力。
The olive oil does not work at all.
田地也不出产。
There's no crops in the plant.
棚内也没有牛。
There's no the ox in the barn.
圈中也没有羊。
And there's no sheep in the herd.
他说：“然而我要因救我的耶和华而欢喜。”
But I want to be glad because of the Lord that saved me.
我要还是要赞美他。
I will continue to praise him.
他使我的脚快如母鹿的蹄。
He caused my feet is runs like a deer.
稳行在高处上。
And we're so firm on this heights, on the heights.
那是敬拜。
That is worship.
敬拜不看环境。
Now worship regardless of situation.
然后我们才有外在的赞美。
And then there will be this external praise.
并且每一个敬拜一定带来大使命。
So every worship will bring about the great commission.
你发觉。圣经里面有个两个敬拜的高峰。
Well, there are two worship peak in the Bible.
第一个敬拜是在以赛亚书第六章。
The first worship experience is in Isaiah chapter 6.
以赛亚看见耶和华的荣耀。
And Isaiah saw the glory of the Lord.
他说：“我是嘴唇不洁的，住在嘴唇不洁的人当中。”
He says that I'm a man of unclean lips, and I live among and people of unclean lips.
可是上帝洁净了他。
But God cleansed his lips.
上帝告诉他说。
God speak to him.
我能差遣谁呢？我们能差遣谁？谁能为我们而去呢
？He said, "Whom shall I send? Who will go for us?"
以赛亚说：“我在这里，请差遣我。”
Isaiah said, "Here I am. Send me."
敬拜带来差传。
Now worship will bring about commissioning.
所以在启示录第七章。
Therefore, in Revelation chapter 7,
我们看见羔羊的前的命敬拜。
You can see that the worship before the Lamb of God.
大使命的完成。
That's the completion of the Great Commission.
造成世界有各民各方。万民都来到羔羊宝座前。
You can see that all tongues, all nations, all tribes that come before the throne of God.
这是大使命的结果。
So this is the result of the Great Commission.
羔羊宝座前的敬拜。
That's the worship before the Lamb of the throne of the Lamb.
你看两个敬拜的高峰。
The two worship peak.
是大使命连接起来的。
It's the integration of the Great Commission.
所以你发现大使命多么重要。
So you can see that it's so important on this concept of the Great Commission.
所以你看整个的敬拜侍奉。
So you can see that the whole worship service.
一定要从心开始。
Now from the heart, that begins from the heart.
心要产生对耶和华的敬畏。
So this heart will have reverence towards the Lord.
所以祭司的臣服。
Therefore, the submission of the priest.
所以 worship 啊，有一种就是完全趴倒在上帝面前。
So worship has this element of prostrating.
就好像在我们以前的大臣们来朝见上早朝一样。
No, just like the officials come before the king.
那个 emperor 还没出，那个皇帝还没有出来之前。
So before the emperor came for the meeting.
他们都要排好队。
So everyone are in line in their position.
然后呢，当皇帝出来的时候。
So when the emperor is on his throne,
他的大臣们都趴倒在地上。
So all the officials portray themselves.
吾王万岁，万岁，万万。
The hail to the king. Here's the thousands and thousands of years.
是心完全的臣服。
So that is the whole heart prostrating before the Lord.
五体投地趴倒在地上。
That is prostrating on the ground.
所以这是在乎你的心的对齐。
So this is the alignment of the heart.
这是祭司性。
That is the priesthood.
所以祭司最大的强点啊，最大的重点就是敬拜。
So the most important point of priesthood is worship.
所以同样的，今天我们教会的是我们的也是一样，我们赞美敬拜。
No, you can see that in the church we have praise and we have worship.
我们借着敬拜
through worship,
我们借着赞美
through praise,
把上帝的宝座设立在我们当中
and to establish God's throne.
神在我们当中的时候
when God is among us,
我们这些做牧师的
our pastors,
就好像太监一样
just like the eunuch,
出来
and come out.
拉开圣旨
and we open up this command.
皇帝召耶
and thus says the Lord, hear ye, hear ye.
讲皇帝的旨意是什么
and to display the intention of the king.
所以今天讲台
so the pulpit today,
不是讲人话，是讲上帝的旨意。
We are not to speak the words of men, but to inform them about the will of God.
是讲台，不是炮台。
It's actually a pulpit that preached the word and not for firing purposes.
是讲神的道。
It's all about the word of God.
你想，如果那个太监出来乱讲，不是那个皇帝已经盖了印的，他会怎样？
No, you said the eunuch when he declared the words that's not from the emperor, what will happen to him?
就被砍头
了。So you'll be beheaded.
所以呢，我们在崇拜的时候呢，我们讲听命。
So during our worship service, we say we need to listen to the command.
是跟身体对齐的。
That is in line with the truth.
然后听命了以后，我们要去遵行。
So after we listen to the word, we have to obey.
所以你发现先知性恢复了，就要君王。
So it's again the restoration of prophet, then come the restoration of the king.
所以我们从 heart 心到头
，and we from the heart to the head,
然后到手
，then to the hands,
去遵行
，to obey.
这个叫做是。
This is what it means by service.
可是今天很多人对侍奉只是停留在这里。
But many has this concept of service in the hand aspect.
心不对了。
But our hearts are not right.
你做什么都没用。
Whatever that we do are in vain.
所以圣经讲说，听命胜于献祭。
Therefore, the Bible says that submission is more important than sacrifice.
你献多少祭都没用。
So as much as you want to sacrifice,
听命不才来献祭。
But you have to listen, submit before you sacrifice.
你心不对的。
If your heart is not right,
人就不对了。
And your this person is not right.
人不对的事情就不对了。
So this when this person is not right, everything that he does is not right as well.
所以这个才是侍奉。
So this is service.
这是在基督里面的侍奉。
There's a service in Christ.
这样我们在职场上呢
？In the marketplace.
你要知道我们的工作就是侍奉。
So you have to know that our work is our service.
因为工作就是敬拜。
Because work is worship.
在原文里面 ，avoda 就是敬拜的意思。
So in the original text, avoda is worship.
所以今天有一个大问题。
So that's a big problem today.
因为在职场里面，我们常常，哎呀，在职场里面真的是，哎呀呀，哎呀呀，来到星期天，我们在哈利路亚。
Now you see that now during weekdays we 哎呀呀 throughout the weekdays and we come to weekend we hallelujah.
所以我们一边哎呀呀，一边哈利路亚。
So we will move from 哎呀呀 to hallelujah.
我们一边。我们的没有把我们的工作看成是一个侍奉。
So we don't see our work as our service.
我们没有看见我们的工作是 avoda.
We did not see our work as avoda.
我们要知道我们的工作是敬拜。
We have to know that our work is our worship.
我们的工作就是完成神在永恒中造我们的目的。
So our work is accomplished in eternal that God created with a purpose.
所以当我们有这种不是一种整合的侍奉观的时候，我们就把它分裂了。
So if we do not integrate the service concept, we will put them into fragments.
我们以为在教会才是崇拜，在工作就不是崇拜。
We thought that in church is service, but in the work is not service.
这个叫做 dichotomy mindset， 就是二分化的信仰。
So this is a dichotomy mindset.
完全不符合圣经。
It's do not comply this to confirm in the Bible.
希伯来书十二章告诉我们。
In Hebrews chapter 12 it says.
他说一切要被震动的都要被震动。
So all that will be shaken will be shaken.
我们真的。我们要很看见这个时代一切要震动的不要震动，你不要以为现在没事，我告诉你圣经讲的话会应验的。
You have to know that every word of God counts and today you can see that there will be times of shaken.
传道书第九章十二节说
In the book of Ecclesiastes chapter 9,
他说原来人不晓得自己的时候
So that when people do not know themselves
就如鱼被恶网圈住，
Just like a fish in the net.
然后鸟被网抓住。
And the birds are in the snare.
人突然落在祸患当中。
And a man has suddenly fall into suffering.
也是如此。
It's also the same.
前阵子中国大陆有一个我认识的人告诉我。
So there's someone that I know in China that told me this.
才两个月前。
Just 2 months ago,
他在哈利路亚。
He is singing Hallelujah.
因为美国的那个公司给他1000万。
Because there's an enterprise in US gave him this $10 million.
他说，因为中国要他生产。
Because they want him to go into production.
他感谢主哦，有人出本钱给我盖厂房。
He said, "I'm so glad because someone gave me the capital to start a factory."
所以因为他有一千万，他就用这一千万借了很多钱。
Because of this $10 million, he's able to get more loans.
所以他又借了一大堆债务。
And that's he's in debt, a huge debt.
借多差不多七八千万。
About another about $7 to $8 million.
突然间，中美战争中美贸易战。
We have this war between U.S. and China.
突然间，美国说对不起，你们的货我们都不能要了。
So the economic war says that I could not take in your goods anymore.
我们给你的一千万算送给你的礼物。
So the capital that we invest is your is something that compensates you.
这个人必须要宣布破产。
And but this person who has to declare bankruptcy.
哈利路亚一下子变成哎呀呀。
So from Hallelujah is being changed to 哎呀呀。
这个时代变得很快。
So these times of this world change ever fast.
圣经讲说一切要被震动的都要被震动。
It says that everything that is to be shaken will be shaken.
唯有不能震动的才能够存留下来。
Only those that are not shaken will last forever.
所以你发现在希伯来书第十二章二十九节说
So you can see that in Hebrews chapter 12, verse 29,
他说我们既然承受了这不能震动的国，
So since we are the inheritance of this unshakable kingdom，
我们感谢主，我们已经承受了不能震动的国。
So thank God we are the heirs of this unshakable kingdom，
我们若是过渡企业，我们是不能被震动的。
So if we are into kingdom entrepreneurship， we will not be shaken，
就是让我们震动也是为了我们的好处。
If we are being shaken it's all for our own good，
神的管教一定是叫我们更好的。
Because the discipline of God will enrich us， make us better。
他说我们就应该存感恩的心。
He says that therefore let us be thankful，
我们要照做神所喜悦的。
According to what delights the Lord，
就是恢复先知性的对齐。
That is to restore the prophetic alignment。
神的旨意是神所喜悦的。
The will of God is what God's delight。
我们要照做上帝所喜悦的。
According to what is acceptable to Him，
我们用敬畏的心。
With a heart of reverence，
因为他是君王。
Because he is the king，
然后我们用虔诚的心。
And with heart of humility，
来侍奉。
Or in heart of awe to worship him。
所以你发现在基督里面的侍奉，
You can see that once again service in Christ，
先知性的对齐。
The alignment of prophets，
照着神所喜悦。
According to what is acceptable to God，
君王性的对齐。
Alignment of kingship，
有敬畏的心。
Heart of reverence，
然后用虔诚的心。
And heart of humility，
是祭司性的。
That is the restoration of priesthood，
因为这是在基督里面的事。
Because this is service in Christ。
所以圣经在希伯来书第十二章的结束说什么呢？
So in the ending verse of Hebrews 12 it says，
他说因为神就是烈火。
He says that our God is a consuming fire，
我们的工程都要经过的。
And all our projects will have to go through the test of fire。
我们若做什么都是从心里做的话，
If whatever that we do is out of our heart，
是为主而做的话，
And do it unto the Lord，
我们一定从主那里得基业为赏赐。
So we receive this inheritance from God as our reward。
所以哥罗西书三章二十三节，
In Colossians chapter 3 verse 23 it says，
22节说不要在人前的侍奉。
It says that verse 22 do not serve before men。
然后第23节说在无论做什么都是为主而做的。
In verse 23 it says that whatever that we do it unto the Lord。
24节就说我们必从主那里得基业为赏赐。
In verse 24 it says that we shall receive an inheritance from the Lord as a reward。
这个基业就是我们将来的复活的身体。
So this inheritance is our glorious body that we are going to receive in the future。
而在彼得前书第一章四节，
In 1 Peter chapter 1 verse 4 it says，
他说我们承受的这个天上的基业，
So that we receive this inheritance from heaven，
是先知性的，是不毁坏的。
So it's imperishable, it's prophetic，
然后它也不衰残的。
It's unfading，
它是君王性的。
That's the kingship，
它也是不玷污的。
And undefiled，
所以它是祭司性。
That's priesthood，
你发现整个的基业里面，
You can see that the whole inheritance，
也是在基督里面的时候。
It's also a service in Christ，
所以这天上不能衰残的基业。
So this this indestructible inheritance in heaven，
不衰残、不毁坏、不玷污。
Or undefiled and undefined and unfading。
所以所讲的是这个真理、仁义和圣洁的基业。
Then it talks about the inheritance of true righteousness and holiness。
这个基业是上帝要给我们存留的。
So then this inheritance is the God reserved for us。
所以你发觉这个基业，我们所要得的这个基业，其实就是我们复活的身体。
So this inheritance is in actual fact our glorious body。
圣经讲，
The Bible says，
在哥林多前书第三章，
First Corinthians chapter 3
第十节到十五节，
From verse 10 to 15，
他说那已经立好的根基，
Since the foundation that has been established，
这个根基就是基督。
This is Christ，
借着使徒先知立好了。
And through the apostles and prophets that laid the foundation，
我们要留心如何在上面建造。
So we have to pay attention as to how we build on top of it。
我们如果用草木合接，
If we were to build it with wood, hay and straw，
它是不能经火的。
You will not be able to go through fire.
一把火来就把它烧得干干净净。
So when caught fire, it's all gone.
所以有些人是破产进入天堂的。
So can see there are people who are bankrupt entering the kingdom.
所以圣经那边讲说有一些人是紧紧得救的。
And the Bible says that there are those that barely are safe.
有刚刚好爬进天堂门口。
Are just in time, need a time to enter the kingdom.
所以呢，他说我们要用金银和宝石来建造。
He says that we have to build with gold, silver, and costly stones.
金代表信心。
Gold represents faith.
代表先知性的。
That is prophetic alignment.
然后银代表望。
Now, silver represents hope.
是君王性的。
Oh, that's kingship.
然后爱代表宝石，宝石代表爱。
The precious stones represents love.
所以呢，信望爱，或是先知君王祭司。 这基督的范本，说我们要用的是金银和宝石来建造。
So gold, silver, and precious stones are hope, love, and faith. You can see that we need this to build the foundation.
所以我们真的，你发现金银宝石跟草木禾秸有强烈的对比。
So you can see that gold, silver, and precious stones and this wood, hay, and straw has a huge contrast.
金所用的信心是可以经火的，因为它是不毁坏的。
So the faith represented by gold can pass through fire, will not be demolished.
银代表上帝的公义。
Silver represents God's righteousness.
代表神给我们的盼望。
The hope that the Lord gave to us.
所以我们的侍奉是有价值、有意义的。
So therefore our service has meaning and value.
然后用宝石所盖的。
And to establish with this precious stone.
我们要知道是可以存到永远的。
That will last forever.
你发现这是一个两个很强烈的对照。So
this is a very clear, vivid contrast.
那我们今天很多人以为说，哎，那耶稣讲说，我岂不是要为你预备很多地方？很多人以为在想，哎呀，我在天堂究竟是给我独立屋呢，还是 apartment 呢？
And Jesus says that I go to prepare a place for you. Many thought that is that an apartment or bungalow or what kind of houses that Jesus prepared for us.
感谢主，我们的思想很丰富。
Thank God that we have this rich think thoughts.
可是我告诉你，
but I want to let you know this.
圣经讲的刚好跟我们想的是相反的。
So the Bible, what the Bible wants to tell you are a huge contrast as to what you think.
今天很多人得救了，就等着上天堂。
So many are saved and they are waiting for heaven.
所以他每天做礼拜，坐坐等上天堂。
Every day they attend the worship, they sit there to wait.
他在坐着上天堂。
Now he's just sitting by going to heaven.
所以对他们的概念。
For them, this concept,
天堂应该是在云端里面飘来飘去。
So the heaven is like this floating in the air.
在那边玩 violin, 弹钢琴、唱诗到永永远远。
To play the harp and to sing till forever and ever.
这些都是教会给我们的这些观念。
This is the concept from the church.
所以我们每一次坐坐礼拜等上天堂。
So every time you attend the church service, you just sit there and wait to.
所以难怪我们跟他们讲职场侍奉说你们不符合真理。
So when we talk about this marketplace ministry, that this is not biblical, they say.
就是世界都要被完全炸得粉碎了，你还做什么职场？
So say the marketplace will end one day. Why do you do marketplace ministry?
你的 eschatology determine your, you know, how you do things.
你这个末世论呢，将决定你怎么样子做事。
换句话说，我们对圣经的明白很重要。So
in other words, we need to really understand the Bible. That's very important.
我们况且不要听谁对谁错，圣经讲什么。So
we do not want to sway to one doctrine or the other. Let's come back to the Word.
圣经主导文教我们怎么祷告。No,
how does the Word of the Lord's Prayer teach us to pray?
愿你的国降临。So
may your kingdom come.
今天的教会是愿你的国上去。Now
today the Bible says that may your kingdom ascend.
我们每天都要上去，要上去。So
everyone is waiting to be ascended.
所以呢，你发觉整个美国在一代里面失去了，因为没有国度神学。Because
of without this kingdom theology, in one generation the whole U.S. collapsed.
每一天在谈 rapture.
Now every day the church talks about rapture in U.S.
逃避式的神学。
And to escape this escape theology,
不是圣经的神学。
It's not the theology of the Bible.
其实圣经讲到被提的时候，
when the Bible talks about rapture,
他用的字，
the word that is being used,
那天我讲帖撒罗尼迦前书四章十七节。
Told you about the First Thessalonians chapter 4 verse 17.
他说第七号天使吹响的时候。
Says that the seventh trumpet is being blown.
他说我们的那些死的人要复活。
That those who are dead will first be resurrected.
然后我们身体要改变。
And our body will be transformed.
然后我们要得着荣耀的身体。
They will receive this glorious body.
我们要被提到空中。
And we'll be raised into the clouds.
所以被提是被提到空中。
That's caught up together in the clouds in the air.
空中是第一层天。
That is the first heaven in the air.
耶稣基督从第三层天下来。
Jesus came down from the third heaven.
要经过第二层天。
Pass through the second heaven.
来到第一层天。
Come to the first heaven.
与圣徒相遇。
And to meet with the saints.
相遇这个字在原文用的是 Pentesis.
Meet is in original words called Pentesis.
这个字的意思是迎接君王的意思。
That is to receive the king.
在马太福音二十五章一节翻译的比较对。
In Matthew chapter 25 verse 1 translated well.
不是翻成相遇，而是迎接。
It's not a meeting up, but to receive.
因为Pentesis 这个字是当王要回来的时候，我们到门口，好像第一层天就是门口，把这个荣耀的王欢迎回来。
When the glorious king is here, we are to go to the gates and to open the gates and receive the king back.
所以我们是上到空中，把主接回到地上做王。
So we are to meet the Lord in the clouds and to bring him back to the earth to reign.
可是我们人想象力很厉害。
But we have this marvelous creativity.
我们常常想上去。
We always think of ascending.
所以呢，我们就想说，哎，主回来的时候，哦，把我接到天上度蜜月七年，然后再回来。
We have been when Jesus returned and bring us back to heaven, and we have 7 years of
high. 这不是圣经的道理。
So this is not the theory of the Bible.
神说你的国降临不是上去。
He said your kingdom come, it's not your kingdom ascended.
圣经最后还说
In the last, the Bible says,
新耶路撒冷要从天而降。
The new Jerusalem will come down from heaven.
神的帐幕在人间。
The tabernacle of the Lord will be among people.
不是神的帐幕在天堂。
It's not the tabernacle of the Lord in heaven.
你发现人把圣经改了。
You can see the man twist the Bible.
所以我们过去很多错误的观念。
So we have this wrong concept in the past.
所以当我们在读到耶稣在约翰福音十四章六节说，十四章一节说，我去要为你们预备地方。
So in John chapter 14 verse 1 it says, I go so that I can prepare a place for
you. 我们不读整篇经文，我们只读那一处啊，上帝为我造一间独立屋。
So we did not
高层的用金做的。
So we did not read the whole passage. Say, oh God, prepared a place for me, and It's a place with gold.
Yeah. 对不起，他太激烈，所以没有电量。其次呢，如果你看经文的背景
，So if you were to look at the Bible passage background，
是多马问一个问题。
It's a Thomas that actually speak. I ask this question.
多马说：“主啊。”我们都不知道你要到哪里去，我们怎么知道这条道路呢
？It says, "Lord, we do not know where you go. How do we know the path?"
多马说，在想，哎，上帝啊，你就是去了云端哪个地方？我们要跟你到哪里去
？Thomas was thinking, "You are entering to the clouds. So which path should we follow?"
所以有一节经文，我们大家都很清楚的。
So there's this passage that we are very familiar with.
在十四章六节。
In verse 6, chapter 14, verse 6.
耶稣怎么回答他？
Now, how does Jesus answer him?
我就是道路。
I am the way.
我就是真理。
I am the truth.
我就是生命。
I am the life.
人如果借助我，不能到父那里。
And without me, no one can go without except through me to the Father.
耶稣回答，没有告诉他，我在天上跟你盖一间房子。他以后来，保罗有很多处的经文告诉我们说，这我们。神的国要来到地上。
So in many passages, it says that God's kingdom will come upon the earth.
所以呢，当我们对这种观念、对职场是很重要的。
So to have such a concept is very important for our marketplace evangelism.
保罗在解析荣耀的身体的时候。
So when Paul teach about this glorious body, resurrected body,
也跟耶稣所讲的这个范本是一样的。
It's similar to what Christ mentioned here, the template.
在哥林多前书十五章四十二节到四十三节。
In First Corinthians chapter 15, verses
42:43. 换句话说，他说说种下的必毁坏的，
播
过的必不毁坏的。
And says that what is planted will perish,
but what resurrected will be imperishable.
Yeah, what resurrected will be imperishable.
那是先知性的。
So that is about prophetic.
种下的是软弱的，复活的却是刚强的。
What is being planted is weak. What is resurrected is strong.
是君王性的。
That's kingship.
种下的是羞辱的，复活的是荣耀的。
What is being planted are shame. What is being resurrected are glory.
这是祭司性的。
That's priesthood.
你发觉保罗在哥林多后书第四章十六节说
So in 2 Corinthians chapter 4 verse 6
chapter 4 verse 16他讲说你们不要善胆你们不要怕
So in 2 Corinthians chapter 4 verse 16 says do not lose heart
虽然你这个身体渐渐毁坏
Though outwardly we are wasting away
可是你心灵是新事一天的。
Yet inwardly are renewed day by day.
上帝一定会预备你这个复活的身体。
God will prepare our resurrected body.
所以第十七节他就说。
Therefore in verse 17 it says.
他说你这自战自轻的苦主要成就将来极大的荣耀。
He says our light and momentary troubles are achieving for us an eternal glory.
所以我们所顾念的不是那看得见的，而是那看不见的。
Therefore, what we fix our eyes on is not on what is seen, but what is unseen.
然后第五章就开始讲得很清楚这个复活的身体。
So, and in chapter 5 begins to talk about this resurrected body.
他讲说，有一天我们地上这个帐门要脱下。
He says that one day our earthly tent will be destroyed.
我们这个地上的这个房子。
And this earthly tent.
要脱下来。
We'll take it down, destroy.
我们要穿上。非人手所造的天上的居所。
So we are had to put on not built by man this eternal house in heaven.
就是复活的身体。
That is the resurrected body.
所以我们的赏赐是复活的身体。
Therefore our reward is a resurrected body.
第十节肯再加肯定。
Now and in verse 10 it confirms even more.
讲到基督台前的审判。
It talks about the judgment seat of Christ.
我们在身体里面所做的，上帝要给我们预备怎样的身体
？So whatever that we do, yeah, will determine the body that the Lord will prepare for us.
我最后用一个故事来结束。
I'd like to end with this one story.
有一个经理。
So that's a manager.
他服侍了这公司几十年。
So he has served this company for the decades.
他来到退休的时候
，So come to the point of retirement.
他可能不知道工作就是敬拜
，So perhaps he does not know that the work is worship.
所以他很想退休
，So he wanted to retire so much.
不知道工作要敬拜的人马上就很想退休。
Now for those who don't know that work is worship, will want to retire soon.
你发现一些很快退休的人就很快进棺材。
You know that those who retired early with it, they will enter into their tomb fast.
因为他生活接下来没有目的。
Because there's no purpose in their living.
我们职场的人，我要知道，我们有人生的下半场。
For those who are in the marketplace, you know that we have the second phase of life.
你一生的输赢不是在你的上半场，打完下半场再来谈。
So your victory or defeat is not based on the first half, but the second half.
很多人下半场都是失败的。
But many are fail in the second half.
所以我们基督徒一定要把这个退休拿掉。
So we have to take away this retirement for Christians. Remove this retirement concept.
There's no such thing as retire, only refire.
没有退休，而是呢能够再次被燃烧。
没有换轮胎，没有退休，只有换轮胎。
There's no retirement, but retire a new tire.
以前是 make in Malaysia, 以后变成 make in German.
So it's made in Malaysia or made in German.
换句话说，我们是没有退休的。
So in other words, that there's no retirement for us.
这个人呢，叫做等着，每一天等着退休拿退休金。
So this man is waiting for that point of time of retirement and for to receive the.
我们马来西亚就讲，从此以后各样嘎叽。
No, in Malaysia, we say that after this, when we go on kaki, that means we shake our leg.
没事情做。
So that means we do nothing.
我发现我有一些朋友没有信仰的。
So for my friends who do not have faith.
我进来跟他们在聚在一起的时候。
So when we gather together for fellowship.
我的师母讲说，哎，奇怪，你的同学怎么都比你老这么多
？He says, why? You're the same batch. Your friends are all looks older than you.
啊，我说我没退休，他们退休了。
He says, because I've not retired, but they have retired long ago.
所以这个人呢，他就很快要退休。
And this man is going to retire soon.
他巴不得快点退休。
So he hope that I can to retire as soon as possible.
因为他没有人生的任何目的。
Because he has no purpose in life.
可是他老板告诉他说。
And the boss said to him.
哇，你做工很尽责任。
Oh, you are very dedicated in your work.
是我请求你再跟我做最后一件事。
He says, I want a last assignment for you.
他说，我还有最后一间房子要盖。
And I have this last project that I need to build.
你把它盖完。
You have complete the project.
然后你就可以退休。
Then you can retire.
那个经理心不甘情不愿。
And this manager is relentlessly.
既然是老板讲的
since it's a word from the boss,
没有办法
I have no choice.
啊，就用最快的方法
So I will just complete the project as soon as possible. The fastest way.
八个月，他用两个月就盖完了
So the eight months project completed in 2 months.
他的没有 quality control 用最糟糕的东西
Without quality controls and with poor materials to build.
一个人没有心做事情，你就知道
So a person without heart in doing things that way.
他盖完的时候
So once he completed the whole project,
老板，我做完了，我要退休了。
Say, boss, I completed the project. I want to retire.
老板说。
Say, boss, say,
你这么忠心的员工。
So since you are so faithful man,
我想了很久，不知道要赏赐你什么。
So I think for a long time, what should I give you as a reward?
你盖完这个房子就是你的退休金。
So the house that you built is your reward.
你所新添就是盖你将来的。
So you are actually building your future house.
所以耶稣保罗在哥林多后书十五章说。
So in the Second Corinthians chapter 15 it says.
他花了五十八节经文讲到复活的身体。
He spent this 58 verses.
最后一节经文说。
In the last verse it says.
是我亲爱的弟兄。
My dear brothers and sisters.
你们务要坚固，不可摇动。
So you have to hold fast and not to be shaken.
你要知道你在主里的劳苦。不是徒然的。
So you have to know that your labor in Christ is not in vain.
我告诉你，一生中一切不徒然的，就在基督里面做的。
So all things that you do that's not in vain is done in Christ.
你不在基督里面做的都没有意义，没有价值。
So whatever the things that you do is not in Christ, there's no meaning and no value.
你的世界做多大的企业都好，都是草木和秸。
Now how big is your enterprise? It's just wood, hay, and straw.
你赚了多多钱，只能成为你阴间的财物。
So as all the wealth that you gain is just combustion material for hellfire.
但是如果我们无论做什么
whatever that you do.
我们从心里做
If it's out of the heart,
我们为主而做
and do it unto the Lord,
我们必从主那里得基业为赏赐
We will receive from the Lord an inheritance as our reward.
这个基业就是你复活的身体
and this inheritance is your resurrected body.
我今天没有时间讲复活身体是怎样的
No, I can't describe it to you what is the resurrected body.
应该讲了以后，你更会服侍。
If I were to tell you, you will truly want to serve.
啊，你这服侍就不会在人前的侍奉。
And your service will not be before men.
你要知道，上帝看重你做的每一件事。
Because God treasures every work that you do.
要记得，天上不是工厂。
You know that the heaven is not communism.
有些人以为说，哎呀，不要紧，这么努力做什么？回去大家都吃穿白衣，要庸俗。
Said why work so hard? Because when we are there, basically we wear this white robe and we wave with these branches.
可是有与主同坐在宝座上。
But there's this thing called to reign with God with Christ on the throne.
他说得胜的
the victorious.
我必赐他同坐在宝座上
，and I will give him this authority to sit to reign.
就如我得胜
，just as I am victorious.
父赐给我的宝座
，and God enthroned me.
那个是在启示录第三章二十一节。
Oh, that's in Hebrews chapter and in Revelation chapter 3.
我们一起祷告。
Let's pray.
天父，我们感谢。
Father God, I want to give thanks to you.
我们知道我们人所要讲的非常有限。
Lord, we know that there's no limit in our words of man.
我们求真理的圣灵继续的来教导我们。
So we pray that the Spirit of Truth teach us in new season.
愿真理的圣灵常常在我们心中做提醒的工作。
May the Spirit of Truth continually teach us.
要让我们明白，我们无论做什么，要从心里做，是为主而做的。
That whatever that we do is from our heart and do it unto the Lord.
因为我们必从主那里得基业为赏赐。
Because we are going to receive this inheritance from the Lord.
主啊，就是我们在学习也是敬拜。
So even though as we learn, we are also worship.
我们在学习当中要竭力认识基督。
So in learning, Lord, we want to strive to know Christ.
让我们的生命是能高举基督。
That our life will lift Jesus high.
使到我们可以传扬基督。
That we can preach Jesus.
因为我们活着就是基督。
Because for us to live is Christ.
我们就是死了，对我们也有益处。
To die is gain.
感谢主。
Thank you, Jesus.
听我们的祷告。
Hear our prayer.
奉耶稣宝贵名祈求。
In the precious name of our Lord Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Amen.